We've all heard the news today. Zalock 23 cut off his 10-year freeform locks. I'm just out getting some food right now, and I feel like this is a good time to vlog about Zalock 23 lock chop. So let's get into it.
Y'all out there, all my lock family out there, I know y'all see a different change within me. It's fairly apparent. And with time comes progression. And I'm on a spiritual journey. I'm trying to understand, I'm trying to get knowledge of myself, who I am. I'm trying to get knowledge of creation around me. I'm trying to get knowledge of my existence. You understand? Now, if I don't manipulate my hair and let it grow naturally, no twisting, no nothing, it locks naturally. It's almost like I'm rediscovering myself. So I'm choosing the freeform route. Letting them grow naturally. It's just a new journey of self. I switched up the way I eat. I eat healthy. I drink nothing but water. I don't drink juice. I don't drink soda. I'm vegetarian now. All I eat is food from the ground. So I'm trying to get back to a natural way of life. I feel like we've gotten away from creation. And I can't wait for my natural locks to get long, to grow.
Thrice month lock up day. Check me out.
Oh yeah. 3 months, y'all.
So, I have a feeling this year gonna come by real quick.
It's gonna feel a whole lot quicker than the first time I locked up. That's how we looking right there.
Give y'all a closer look. So, as y'all can see, they coming along pretty well. Let me show y'all the back a little bit more.
See, this one gonna be a thick one. And I got this one right here.
I wash maybe once every 3 days. Soon as I get out, let my hair dry. You know, I towel rub it. And what I use to moisturize is jojoba oil. Jojoba oil, grapeseed oil, almond oil, castor oil, like these are good oils to moisturize your scalp with. Now, to increase hair growth, what I recommend is y'all to do scalp massages. It makes your scalp breathe more. So the more that your scalp can breathe, the quicker the growth process can take place. Journey seems like this time around, since I'm not looking at the time,
it's going by a whole lot faster. It seems like when you're looking at the time, it's like it's stagnant. You know, it ain't going nowhere. So I feel like, you know, my consciousness has also been raising since me locking for these 7 months. And hey, I give thanks for that. Performing for 1 year, one solid year, and my first year was October 9th. So I give thanks for this whole year. I'm talking about, man, freeform is exactly what it is. It's freedom. You know what I'm saying? Freedom. You understand what I'm saying? Free mind. And I feel like when you get to that energy level where you're starting to appreciate who you are, love who you are, how you are naturally manufactured, how you are naturally created, and know that you weren't created this way for no reason. You weren't blessed with the hair with no reason. I feel like a lot of people will then start walking around these streets with pride and dignity that they love what's on top of their head. Understand that naturally, if you let your body do what it do, it will give you wealth. I'm free forming to get closer to my manufactured self, how I was naturally made. Also, as a message to these people out here, to tell them that it's okay to love what is on top of your head. Twisting, completely respecting nature with no twisting, respecting my natural self and loving my natural self. This is an expression of the love that I have for myself. 2 year freeform update. Freedom. Freedom. Life resonates with the natural way of life. You've seen the roots of a tree. You know how some are big, some are small, some are medium sized. They all have their own individual personality. It's the same way with my locks. My scalp being the soil, my hair being the tree. It's like it's just growing. It's growing out of the soil and it's growing longer. I have a thick one. I got a skinny one. I got one that got two heads on it. It's a different journey, and it's a different energy. Check me out, check me out. Side view, check me out, check me out. Blah. Other side, check me out, check me out. You know? And this one kind of hangs, you know what I mean? But I just throw it back But as soon as it gets longer, it's gonna have more weight on it. So then it's gonna be able to hang more. But because it's not long enough just yet, it kind of sticks out like that. So when they get longer, they gonna drop more when they have more weight. Not many people do this. Not many people freeform. It's a separate path. It gets me more in sync with that spirituality. But I lock my hair for spirituality, to get deeper within my natural self.
YouTube world, what's going on, man? Zaylock 23, y'all already know, coming at y'all with another video. Bow.
You know, the locks turned 3 years. Yesterday, you know, so 3 years of freedom, you know, 3 years, and I'm gonna keep on letting them get longer and longer. As soon as my beard come in, I don't shave or nothing. I'm just gonna let all that just come in, just natural, you know what I'm saying? Let my beard come in, boom, you know, just let all that come in real thick, let my hair grow, just be nature, just be in tune. Yo, wisdom, knowledge, overstanding. We give thanks and praise for this life experience. 3 years and 8 months lock update. 3 years and 8 months, working on 4 years. The set that I had before, I have now reached a point to where I've had these longer than the set I had before. I had the other set for about 3 years and 7 months. So now I'm on my 8th month with this set, and I'm gonna keep on letting them grow. I'm gonna let them grow, because the longer my freeform locks grow, the more my wisdom grows. You know what I'm saying? They done got they grow on, you know what I mean? This one like a real long one right here. You know what I'm saying? You know? Side view, man, you already know what I'm about to do. Side view, champion. Bah! Wisdom, knowledge, I understand. There is no separation in creation. Everything is one. Everything is connected. We all come from the same source energy. We all have come from the same source. We've been created from the same source.
May I say something to you to give you a true knowledge of yourself and life, so that the same glory and success attained by other men who understand themselves may be yours? Man, in the full knowledge of himself, is a superb and supreme creature of creation. When man becomes possessor of the knowledge of himself, he becomes master of his environment, the captain of his own ship, the director of his own destiny, the accomplisher of his own ends. Man should understand himself because man is full of knowledge, and this knowledge is a gift of nature. When Mother Nature created man, she deprived him of nothing. He was given the faculty of understanding all things around him. This faculty for understanding has not been taken away from him. None of his senses have been taken away from him. So there is no excuse for the black man in lacking the knowledge that man is used to beautify the world and produce all that he needs for his happiness and civilization. Look the world over, and whatever you see in it that is pleasing to man, contributing to man's comfort, to his needs and to his satisfaction, it is but the work of man. Man blessed with the knowledge of himself and the understanding of all things around him. If you are able to live with the knowledge of yourself and with the greater knowledge of nature, you must know what is good and what is not. You must know what is finite. You must know that which is material, physical, and otherwise is at your disposal to create or otherwise use.
And
growing these natty dreads. That's how we growing them. You know what I'm saying? We growing them natural. You know what I mean? No twisting, no nothing. I'm just letting the Almighty form them. I've never twisted these locks. And that's the vibe. So this is how I've been creating my reality. 5 years. You know what I'm saying? Check me out, check me out. 5 years. So yeah, I can go ahead and do the side view right there. You know, so it's kind of like 5 years. It's like maybe mid back. You know, that's pretty much how it's getting right now. So I kind of just do that right there. Boom. So that's where I give thanks, you know what I'm saying? So that's the vibe right there. So I do want to show y'all, you know, I got that one right there. I think, you know, this one got like a double head to it. You know what I mean? Like, you can see how these locks at the bottom form together, then just matted, and then these two just formed right here. And then it's just been growing as a single one right there. This is another one. This has like two on it. And then I got this piece right there. You know what I'm saying? That's the vibe. That's the vibe. So yeah, check that. Check that. One is right there. And then it just breaks off into two. So that's the vibe right there. Like right below, you know what I'm saying? Like midway to my head, like all the way at the bottom. And so that's what that one's looking like. And this one's pretty thick. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I just kind of wash and I just go. Like some are in the front as well, you know, and these are just kind of together like that. So I do want to show y'all some new ones I got coming in right here. And these just came out of nowhere. So I got these just coming in right here, you know? And yeah, I got like what, two right there and like three. And I imagine this is probably gonna be just like one lock right here, or maybe they'll just stay, you know, where they are. But, you know, yeah, just Bushman vibe right there. So I got those coming in. And yeah, I just got some more like on the sides. So I got like a whole bunch of small locks just coming up. And then I got like the ancient ones, you know, I've been rocking with for a couple years, so. Yeah, so that's the vibe. While we're at it, I do want to show the beard lock. You got a close-up of that? Yeah, so this right here, I've been locking this one for like maybe 4 months. 4 or 5 months I've been locking this one. You know what I'm saying? So every time I wash it, like it never comes out. So I know this is locked already. So it's just pretty much growing. You know what I mean? So I'm definitely letting that lock. And this one, I was just kind of messing around and I just never took it out. You know what I'm saying? So I got like maybe two. Like, you know, this one is the oldest one. This is like the youngest one. I just been letting it just do its thing. This month actually hit 6 years for me. 6 years been having a free form. Those who've been, you know, rocking it with me for a minute, y'all saw the transformation. I first cut my twisted locks off. Then I started growing these as soon as I came into like a deep spiritual consciousness. A lot of people was like, yo, what you doing? Why are you doing that? Like, what, you know, triggered you to even do that? A lot of things that you do in life, it's not like you do it for validation or you do it to please the external world. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, I'm in this creation. This is my world. When I master myself, I master the world. So when there's creatures outside of me or there's different life forms that's outside of me and they may not understand how I'm creating myself or how I'm mastering myself. That's really a reflection of them. It has nothing to do with me. Those of y'all who know how to tie it, maybe y'all can link me to a video. But I don't know. Soon I see the Rasta man do this, just be like, whoa. Like powerful, powerful natties, you know? Powerful natties. In tune with the creator, you know, in tune with creation. See, look at that. Yeesh, now I just gotta put them all in there. You know what I'm saying? Go something like that. Feel me? Yeesh. Something like that. You know how the Rasta man them
Rastaman them be tying it up.
Yeah, this is like the side view right here. You know what I mean? Check me out. 6 years now, free forming. I've never twisted these locks. Never twisted them. Ever. Ever. Never twisted them. Never twisted these locks. You know what I mean?
I love this one right here, you know. Super thick. These first two, front two ones, super thick.
So when you master this, everything just, the body is a slave to the mind. The body is a slave to the mind because everything that you got on, everything is a thought.
Don't go through it, grow through it. Don't go through it, grow through it. The rose that grew from the crack of the concrete. Perfect love, man. Freeform locks. As they grow, my wisdom grows. 7 years, 2 months. Keep growing your natties, fire ablaze, Babylon. This is how the higher intelligence created me. There is no mess up or mix up in creation. Everything in creation has a purpose. Facts. Babylon, stay connected to the Almighty One, your site, the source. That's where you get all your energy from. 8 years and a half, 8 years, 6 months, I have been free-forming my locks. 8 years and 6 months. 8 years and 6 months. Man, the journey is just, man, the journey
It's a journey, man.
This was my way to decolonize my mind. This was my way. 8 years and 6 months of freeform locks. I've never twisted these. Never twisted these.
Locks is nature. We in nature right now.
That's where all the health is. That's where all the wisdom is. That's where all the insight, that's where all the understanding comes from, is in nature. Because it wasn't you yourself that created yourself. It was the intelligence. But the intelligence dwells within. The intelligence dwells in nature. So to connect with that higher intelligence, get in tune with nature. Gotta get this wisdom, gotta get this knowledge, gotta get this divine understanding, man. Wherever you are on this beautiful planet, man, I'm sending you enough love, positive vibrations, peace. 9 years. 9 years. I've had my locks now. Never twisted. I've never twisted my locks, all right? And it just all began when I started learning about myself. When I started really getting into my history. When I started really getting into my history, when I really started to research my ancestors. With the freeform locks, for me, it symbolizes how I'm coming up in spirituality, wisdom, and insight. Also, I want to show you all this beard lock, my beard lock update. Yes, I am locking my beard as well, locking my hair and my beard. You can see how long it's getting. I actually got a little small one coming in. Right there, I'm gonna let it thicken up a little bit, but this one is like super thick, you know, it's real healthy. This one is like a new one that's kind of forming, you know what I mean? So I'm growing locks on my beard and just letting them things grow long as well.
Thickest one,
you know what I mean? So I actually joined this one. So you see how it's thick right here, but then it gets thin right here. So I joined two to make this. And so now this one was making a thick lock, and then out of nowhere, I guess just from me washing it, it started to lock with the lock right next to it. So now this is a whole lock. So now these two are one.
And it's funny to me because when people say they notice a trend when people start to trim their locks, they're soon to come to cut them all off after. And you know, this kind of solidified that for me in this little chapter of Zaylock's life.
I trimmed my locks, family. I trimmed my locks. I know a lot of ones and ones are saying like, why? The simple, simple answer is because of the weight. I like to travel light. I also love to run. I love fitness. I love being active, you know, things like that. So I've been growing these for 10 years, 10 years straight. And that was actually my first time cutting. This is what I've cut off, you know, and they still look, you know, pretty long, but you know, I just had to free myself up small, you know? As you all can see, it's a big change, y'all. It's a big change, a humongous change, a 10-year change. You know, I was in that lock game for about 10 years.
okay, 10 years, and I was like, yo, on that 10th year, you know, they was getting super, super long, and I'm just like, man, the weight, and I'm just like, man. Let me tell you all, it was not easy. It was not easy, you know, because, I mean, imagine doing something for 10 years and then you switch it up, you know. I'm so glad I did it. There is no regrets whatsoever. Like, I literally cut right at the new growth. So you all can see, you know, nice and thick. I'm talking about, I haven't put my actual like fingers, like, you know, to really come into the scalp in 10 years, a long time. I just feel like I got to a certain level within myself where I'm like, I can close the chapter on that particular journey. Yeah, family, just so you all can see the texture, you know, side view, check me out, you know, my day ones, my OGs, y'all remember that? Check me out, you know, it's the back, I cut it right at the new growth, yeah, but man, it's, wow. All right, family, so, I got the cut, fam. That's how we looking, bro. That's how we looking. You know what I mean? We got the facial a little tight. We got a little temple fade, you feel me? Did a little temple slash shadow fade. You see the back. Got the curl sponge, you know? Put a little texture to it. Got my curls on top. You know what I'm saying? I felt the air on my neck for like the first time in forever, bruh. Like, wow, like, I really love this, man. It's simple, it's clean, it's, you know what I mean? It's nice, bro. It's nice. So yeah, you know, you wanna check me out? You know, that's the side view, check me out. Go to the other side view, check me out, man. That's how we looking right now, you know? The back, how the back looking, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, a temp fade slash shadow fade. Might as well. All right, family, so, you know, appreciate y'all. So, till next time.
You know, so it's kind of crazy to think about. After 10 years of free-forming locks, decided just to cut them off. Now, Zalok is obviously an OG on the Dread Tube. He's been around since prior to 2010, 2009, doing lock videos before anybody even was doing lock videos. Shout out to Dante86, I was talking to him the other day as well. And he was around the same time as Zalok and Cheska Locks and all that back in the day. But regardless, the event of Zalok cutting off his locks, I have a few opinions myself. I wish that there was some video footage of him actually cutting them. Same with on his trim, he didn't film that process at all. Oh, it says it's ready already. I said my burrito is ready there. I should probably go pick it up.
Hi, I'm picking up. This one is Jonathan. That was quick. I had just called, and then you can put it in the tip jar.
Thank you.
See ya.
In case you're wondering, type of burrito that I buy every time. It's a large whole wheat tortilla. Black beans, refried beans, all toppings, no cheese, with guac, no jalapenos, no burrito sauce, no sour cream. The vegan burrito. We'll be right back.
figured I'd take you guys down by the lakeside and finish this story. Over there in Toronto, downtown is way over there. What are my thoughts on Zay cutting his hair? I mean, there comes a time for everybody, right? Everybody. I don't think I ever met one person that's never cut their locks at some point in their life. I get it, it's gonna be an easier and fresher start as he's starting a new journey over in the motherland, which is so dope to see. See his channel grow from original traditional locks to a freeform lock journey channel and now to just a motherland channel. Dope to see, and I'm super stoked to still be a part of his journey here on YouTube. I'll be watching and learning. Learned so much from Zay. He's the one that inspired my YouTube channel, my freeform locks now. Like, a lot of this has come from Zay's teaching. So gotta get this wisdom, gotta get this knowledge, gotta get the understanding. That's what it's about. So, yeah, just super stoked, actually. My thoughts are, what do you guys think about Zay cutting his locks off? I did ask him on YouTube. I left a comment asking if he's ever gotten any discrimination in Africa regarding his dreads. And he responded that he didn't, really. He said everyone's pretty much pretty peaceful with it. Sorry, my battery died. But he said most people will holler at him, calling Rast, across the street. That's what happens in Jamaica or the Caribbean all the time. If you got dreads and you show up in the islands, everyone calls you Rasta, from across the football field, the way they're calling you for. No reason, just say it. They're just hailing what up, right? They're just saluting. And yeah, that's a good sign of respect. He also said some people might have been a little offended that by having locks in Africa, you're denying their ancestors' roots. You're denying the ancestors' roots of the motherland, because the majority of them out there, the majority of Africans aren't Rasta, right? So it's not their culture, essentially, and they just want to see Africans embracing African culture. But other than that, he said it's all peace and love, which was good to hear, because, you know, I guess you do hear some stories here and there about it in Africa and being a bit more discriminative than here, where they don't allow kids to go to school, where they don't allow people to get jobs with locks. But I guess that's kind of just worldwide. You know, this is gonna be, in every country, there's gonna be discrimination. So we gotta unite and work together to lift that and to ban that discrimination, essentially. But I'm gonna throw this back to the video over at the studio. So I appreciate you guys checking out. This is Not Locks out at the Lake Ontario. Back to you guys back in the studio. Back to you guys in the studio. I mean, there's not much happening back here beyond me just saying I've been spending the whole day editing this video. So, literally started 8 hours ago. So it would mean a lot to me if you guys show some support, like the video, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and definitely check out Zaylock if you haven't. He's got some crazy videos on living and starting a new life in Africa. So, till next time, peace out, one love, stay happy and natty. I'm going to bed. Boom! The freeform locks.